Hello everyone! In this video, we are very excited to present our newest release, Plex-Earth 2025. For those who are already familiar with Plex-Earth, you will see that this version introduces some new concepts, which we are happy to say that they will significantly enhance the overall user experience. For those unfamiliar with our software, it is a design tool which allows users to import geospatial data directly into their AutoCAD drawings. By geospatial data, we mean satellite and aerial imagery, historical imagery, terrain elevation data, and various tools for the communication between Google Earth and AutoCAD. These features enable users to design more accurately, more quickly, and with less risk. So without further ado, let's start. We will begin with the import of satellite and aerial imagery to use them as a background for our design. We'll use a blank drawing without any preset settings. On the upper part of AutoCAD's window, you will see the Plex-Earth ribbon. On the left side of the screen is Plex-Earth's Collection Manager, a useful tool where most of our commands will be executed. Now, let's move to Google Earth, as it is an easy tool to locate our project area. Here, we can create a place mark and copy it. Essentially, we are just copying the coordinates of this point. We will now go back to AutoCAD, and we will click to create a quick site view for easy reference. Here, I can use my coordinates, as the software needs to know our area of interest. Upon acceptance, Plex-Earth will create a quick image in our drawing, placed at the respective coordinates in AutoCAD, and at the correct scale for the area displayed in Google Earth. We now have our area displayed, and since we are interested in importing imagery across this highway, we will create a polyline for our center line. Then, we can click on Create Imagery, and from the various options on how to select the area we want to cover with our imagery, we will select By Route. Let's define the width of our corridor and proceed. The next step is to select the provider that we want. In this list, all the standard and premium providers available for this area are shown. In the Custom Maps field, we can also connect to any WMS or tile server available on the internet. Let's proceed with Google Maps and choose from various datasets like satellite imagery, road maps, or hybrid maps. Notice that here, you can make any selection you want as default. In the next part, we will be asked to define our preferred zoom level. Higher zoom levels require more image tiles to cover the entire area. Note that you will also have the option to choose the exact images you want by ticking the Edit Tile Selection checkbox. For now, let's select Zoom Level 21 and import all the images for our area. It's important to note that each of the images that we will be importing are individually georeferenced, ensuring the highest accuracy offered by the providers. Once ready, you can close the quick view and start editing your image. Here, you can remove the grid lines indicating all the individual images imported to better view the resulting image. You can also go to Tools to edit this image further and adjust parameters like brightness or transparency. And of course, revert to the original state of the image. You can even create clippings or cutouts if you have a polyline. Note that if we save this drawing and open it again, the image will automatically load from Plex-Earth's server. However, if you need to share it with people who do not have Plex-Earth or want to open the images in other software, you can convert this image to a raster image from the Insert menu. Just select if you want the entire image, or your zoom mouse to select just a part of it, as well as the preferred file type. This way, The imagery will be saved locally as a standard image file on your computer and added to the drawing as an extra file, similar to any image added to an AutoCAD drawing. Finally, if we close this imagery, we will be taken to the imagery section of the Collection Manager, where we will be able to see a list of all the imagery imported with Plex-Earth and hide or view any that we want. Now that we saw how quick and easy it is to import an image, let's do the same with the terrain. Since this drawing is not brand new compared to the previous example, we have already assigned a coordinate system and our design is in place. Therefore, we can change the process a little bit. If we click on terrain elevation data, we can directly choose the area that we want in our drawing. We will select the bi-polygon option to get terrain data only within the limits of our polyline. Of course, we could have done the same with the imagery. Our contour lines will be ready in seconds, and then we can get any information about any specific point. In the Contours tab, we can adjust the intervals and the respective colors. By clicking Apply, all these changes will take place. In the next tab, we can add labels to the contour lines. And in the last tab, we can create terrain analysis based on factors like elevation, slopes, and direction. Let's select elevation, define the number of ranges, and the respective colors. Similar to the imagery, we can import all these as AutoCAD elements. More specifically, we can import the contour lines as polylines to edit them, import a thin mesh, or just elevation points. We can also import Civil 3D surface directly if we are working in its environment. Finally, you can add this analysis as an AutoCAD object and generate a detailed analysis table for comprehensive reporting and planning. Again, all the imported terrain will be displayed in the terrain list, which now appears at the top of our manager. In the Tools menu, we can drape imagery we have imported with Plex-Earth onto our terrain to create 3D imagery, or snap objects to our terrain, like these 3D wind turbines over here, for better visualization. Note that you can access additional options by navigating to the upper ribbon and selecting terrain. Here, for example, you can create a terrain model directly from a geotiff file. Let's see this in practice in this drawing from a DTM geotiff file. First, we locate our geotiff file containing terrain data. Define the grid resolution and click on clipping to select only the area we want. Plex-Earth will generate the terrain model based on the provided data. Similarly, you can also create terrain models from existing contour lines you might have or CSV files. Finally, you can even calculate cut and fill volumes between existing and proposed terrains. By selecting the respective terrains and initiating the calculation, Plex-Earth visually displays the results on your AutoCAD screen. This feature provides valuable insights into earthworks within the AutoCAD environment. Now that we have an understanding of the imagery and terrain features, let's introduce the concept of site areas. With site areas, you can import all the available data we mentioned for your project area with just a few clicks. Here is our area in Google Earth. Again, we copy the place mark and click on the Create a Site Area button. A quick view of our area is then displayed on our drawing. We can reduce its size if we want, and proceed with our site area. Since we can have multiple site areas in our drawing, we can enter a name for quick reference. Here, you can get various information about our quick view in the Explorer tab, like the provider, the area size, and the coordinates of the center of our area, as well as the zoom level of the preview image, which is generally of lower resolution than the best we can get for an area. Most importantly, you can see all the available providers for this specific area from the premium providers, namely Nearmap, Hexagon, Airbus, and Maxar, in addition to our standard providers like Google Maps, Azure Maps, and OpenStreetMaps. We can then move to the Imagery tab, whereas before, we can create our imagery. If we select Nearmap this time, you can see the credit consumption since it is a premium provider. Once our image is imported, if you zoom in, you can see the high quality and resolution of this dataset. We can then proceed to import the contour lines for this area. For both imagery and terrain, we get the same tools as before. Now, pay attention here to the historical tab, which allows you to import imagery spanning from a few days ago to even 15 years back, depending on the area, from Airbus and Maxar, which offer global coverage. Here, you can view the most recent imagery from Airbus. You can also change the location of your area of interest if you want to focus on some other point and import historical imagery there. Notice that each dataset provides useful information like the zoom level available, whether the image is colored or grayscale, as well as the cloud coverage. Now, let's add more dates, such as images from 2023 and 2021. By toggling between these images, you can create a timeline that illustrates how the area has changed over time. By switching between the current imagery and historical imagery, you can compare the differences between these two views of the same area. Now that we've created our first site area, you can see it listed in the site area list. If there are multiple site areas in our drawing, they will all be displayed here for easy access. With Plex-Earth 2025, apart from site areas, you can also create POIs, which are useful if you have a project where you need to mark multiple points of interest. Let's see how this works. Here is a quick view of our location. We will click on the Create Point of Interest button and then choose Multiple Points to identify the various points that are important for our design. In this example, we will mark all the houses in the square. Then, we will mark the spark. Note that for each POI you create, if you edit it, you can get a high quality view of its area, as well as the ability to get historical images and create a timeline. For our final feature, the communication between AutoCAD and Google Earth, you can access the KML tools in Plex-Earth. Here, you will find the import KML-KMZ command. Clicking here allows you to select a KML file for import. Ensure to assign a coordinate system as needed. Alternatively, if you have layers from Google Earth that you wish to import, you can simply copy and paste them into your drawing. Plex-Earth also supports exporting drawings to Google Earth, whether 2D or 3D. You can select the specific layers you want to export and define how you want your drawing to be positioned in Google Earth. Once the KML is created, Plex-Earth automatically navigates you to your area. In addition, for these 3D drawings, we have created various views that you can switch between, which are ideal for creating presentation videos to share with colleagues and partners. Additional tools available include zooming to areas in Google Earth, importing camera photos, and importing or exporting world files, which can be handy during design process. Before we end this video, let's discuss georeferencing. In the previous examples, the georeference was either automatically assigned by Plex-Earth using a UTM coordinate system, or it was assigned manually. To do this, simply click on the Assign Georeference button. If you've already used one, you can also set it as default, or click Change to select a different coordinate system. Specify the country, the respective coordinate system, and ensure the units are correctly defined for your import to be accurately scaled. You can also use the search section to find a specific coordinate system by name or by EPSG number. Once you've made your selections, click Accept to assign the coordinate system. Of course, if your drawing is already georeferenced with AutoCAD via geolocation, Plex-Earth will automatically recognize it and use that setting. So, this pretty much sums up the main features of Plex-Earth. We saw how you can import up-to-date satellite and aerial imagery, historical imagery, import terrain data and create terrain models, as well as visualize your design in Google Earth. We hope you found this video helpful. Feel free to leave a comment, subscribe for updates on Plex-Earth, and don't hesitate to contact us at support@plexearth.com. Visit our website to try our free trial at www.plexearth.com. Thank you very much for watching.